The gate characteristics is over now. Now the next one is triggering. The triggering circuits we are studying. The turning on process of SCR is known as a triggering. In other words, turning the SCR from forward blocking state to forward conduction state is known as triggering. So we know there are different methods of starting SCR. Like in VI characteristics we studied, there are three modes of operation of SCR. If we keep on increasing the voltage, at one point the avalanche breakdown takes place at junction J2 and it will start conducting. So that is one method. And one more method is, if we apply the gate pulse, that it will start immediately, that it won't take much voltage to start SCR. So again, that two methods is by increasing the voltage and by giving the gate pulse along with the voltage. So that is one method. So here we study the different methods of starting SCR. That is, the triggering is nothing but how we can start the SCR. So there are basically five methods to start the SCR. The first one is forward voltage triggering, temperature triggering, radiation or light triggering, dv by dt triggering, gate triggering. The first one we studied, that is forward voltage triggering. So in this mode of operation, as name says, forward voltage, you can see in the below graph the same PNPN, that is a SCR, 4 layer 3 junction device with a gate circuit open, still we can start the SCR. That is nothing but a forward blocking mode to forward conduction mode method. The three modes of operation, whatever we studied, so the same thing. If we apply the voltage initially without the gate pulse, the current, a small amount of a leakage current will flow through the SCR, that you can see here in the graph, this part. So this explain about this part. So if we keep on increasing the voltage, the small amount of a leakage current will flow through the SCR, that is forward leakage current. So at one point, that is a breakover takes place, that is the avalanche breakdown takes place at junction J2, and immediately the current will raise and voltage will decrease. So this part, so current suddenly increases and voltage decreases. So that is what we already explained, this one, that is after forward blocking mode to it will jump to a conduction mode, that is explained here. If we keep on increasing the voltage, that is anode to cathode voltage, that is in when it is in forward bias, if we keep on increasing that voltage, then automatically the SCR will start conducting. See, when the anode terminal is positive with respect to cathode, that is a VAK, the junction J1 and J3 is forward biased and junction J2 is reverse biased. No current flows through the depletion region, that is because it's a reverse biased. Reverse in the sense, N is connected to positive, P is connected to negative. For that reason, we are saying it as a J2 is reverse biased. But still, a small amount of a leakage current flows through the SCR. If we keep on increasing that voltage, then a breakover will take place at junction J2 and it will start conducting. So this is one method of triggering SCR, the starting method of SCR. Next one is thermal or temperature triggering. As name says, thermal, that is nothing but a temperature method of triggering. We know one concept, that as we increase the temperature, that is how electron move from the valence band to a conduction band, is by increasing the temperature at 0 Kelvin, they won't move. So when we increase the temperature, they gain energy and they will start conducting. They will move from conduction band to a valence band to a conduction band. So when they are in conduction band, they can move freely. So when we give temperature, then they will gain energy. Whatever the electrons which are present in a valence band, they will gain energy. Similarly here, the width of the depletion layer of SCR decreases. That is, the junction J2 decreases with increase in temperature. So if we keep on increasing the temperature, the depletion layer will decreases, and finally the electrons will start to move, the charge carriers will start to move in the SCR. Therefore, in SCR, when VA is very near its breakdown voltage, the device is triggered by increasing the junction temperature. See, only by increasing the temperature we are not starting the SCR. Along with the anode to cathode voltage, we are giving a temperature. Along with that, we are giving a temperature, then it will conduct. That is the anode to cathode voltage, that is a, before VBO, forward breakover voltage is there, no? Before that only it is possible to start the SCR by increasing the temperature. The next method is radiation or light triggering. So as name says, light triggering. So we are applying the light energy for the SCR to make it start. So for light triggering SCR, a special terminal, that is a niche, that is a triggering. As name says, we are applying the light energy for the SCR to make a reverse bias junction J2 to a forward bias junction. Here one terminal, that is a niche, is provided inside the P-type terminal, as you can see on the figure. So if we when a light is allowed to strike to this terminal, the free charge carriers are generated. When the intensity of the light becomes more than the normal value, the thyristor starts conducting. So junction J2 will become a forward biased by applying the light energy. When we apply the light energy, the free charge carriers are generated inside the junction J2. So it will become forward biased. So we can call this type of SCR also as a, here the instead of a gate terminal, that is a niche a terminal is provided. At the same place like where a gate terminal is there, no? So there only a terminal, that is the niche, is provided. This type of SCR is also called as a LASCR, that is a light activated SCR. The next method is dV by dt triggering. dV by dt is nothing but the rate of change of voltage, the rate of change of voltage with respect to the time. So when that is possible, then also we can start the SCR. How? We see now, when the device is forward biased, that is when anode is connected to the positive terminal and cathode is connected to the negative terminal, junction J1 and J3 is forward biased and junction J2 is reverse biased. So the junction J2 behaves as a capacitor, that is a dielectric media, media will be there, and two layers acts like a capacitor. So then a capacitive voltage will exist in that junction J2. So we know the basic formula, that is I is equals to dq by dt. Here, this part, we know I is equals to dq by dt, that is the rate of change of charges with respect to time. And the basic formula of the capacitor, that is q is equals to cv. That's a basic formula for the capacitor. If you put the value of Q is equals to CV in the above equation, that is I is equals to D, instead of a Q, I can put here as a CV by DT. So that is written over here, IC is equals to DCV by DT. So if I differentiate C and V with respect to time, then I can write it as a C into dV by dt plus V into dC by dt. That is a differentiation of CV. But dC by dt, that is a constant which is equals to 0. The left out part is IC is equals to C dV by dt. So what we can say, by the rate of change of voltage across the device becomes large, then there is a chances of current flow through the SCR. That is from the equation we can see. IC is equals to C dV by dt. So if a rate of change of voltage is increases, then the current may flow through the SCR. This is another method of starting SCR. The next one is a popular, the most widely used is a gate triggering circuits. Applying the positive voltage between the gate and cathode can turn on a SCR forward biased thyristor. When a positive voltage is applied at a gate terminal, a charge carriers are injected in the inner layer of P, thereby reducing the depletion layer thickness. As the applied voltage increases, the carrier injection increases. Therefore, the voltage at which the forward breakover occurs decreases. So what it says, the whatever the methods which I explained now is rarely used type of methods. The commonly used one is a gate triggering circuit. So in case of a VI characteristics of a CR, there is one circuit. In order to give a gate pulse, there is one power circuit as well as a control circuit in SCR. Control circuit is nothing but where we are giving the gate pulses, no? So that will control the SCR. So that is a control circuit, and power circuit is the major part. Like once it will start conducting, it will take a more power. But in order to start that SCR, we required a little amount of a gate pulse. That is a control circuit as well as a power circuit. Two types of circuits are there in SCR. So for that reason, as a gate terminal which requires a less amount of a power to trigger the circuit, so that part we are isolating it from the power circuit. So how we can give the triggering pulses or a triggering voltage, triggering value to the SCR is by using triggering circuit. So if we give in case of VI characteristics of a forward conduction mode as well as a forward blocking mode, so if we give the gate current, then the voltage required to turn on the SCR, the voltage required to turn on the SCR will be less. That is, VBO is less when we apply the gate current. Remember the gate characteristics. If we apply IG, means it will not take a VBO, that much of voltage it won't take. So it will immediately starts to conduct if we provide a gate pulse. That is what it's written in the fourth point. As the applied voltage increases, the carrier injection increases, therefore the voltage at which the forward breakover occurs, that decreases. Here the applied voltage, in the sense, that is not a power circuit voltage, that is not a V anode to cathode. The only voltage which we are applying to the gate terminal to the cathode, that voltage if we apply, then VBO will decrease. There are three methods here in case of gate triggering. The first one is a DC gate triggering, AC gate triggering, pulse gate triggering. So as name says, the DC gate triggering, a DC voltage of a proper polarity is applied between the gate to cathode terminal. I will show the circuit of a particular that triggering circuit of SCR. The same thing which is given in gate characteristics, no? That same circuit. From gate to cathode, whatever the voltage we are applying, no? That voltage here in case of a DC triggering, that is a DC. When applied voltage is sufficient to produce a required gate current, the device starts conducting. So the theory is over here. But here in case of a DC, there is one drawback. That is, isolation is not possible here, because for isolation, because we have two types of circuit, as I told you, the power as well as the control circuit. So if we give the voltage, that is a DC voltage, it's not possible for us to provide a proper isolation in case of a DC triggering. So that is one disadvantage, as well as the power loss is more in this case of a triggering, that is DC gate triggering. The next one is AC gate triggering. Here AC source is used for a gate signal. That is, between the gate terminal to the cathode, whatever the voltage we are applying is here is a AC. So as AC, name says as AC, so we can use a transformer for isolation purpose. So isolation is possible here. that is between the control circuit as well as a power circuit. The drawback of this one is a separate transformer is required for isolation over here, that is AC triggering. The last one is a most widely used method is a pulse gate triggering. So again here, in case of a AC triggering, that is the whatever the voltage which we are giving to the SCR is continuously, it will reach to a positive peak as well as a negative peak. So when it is in a positive voltage, we know the characteristics of SCR, what it says, when we give the required voltage, it will start conducting. If we, even after that, if we remove that pulse, it will still be in on condition only. So continuous positive as well as a negative peak is there in case of a AC triggering. Again, one diode we have to use for in order to provide a positive pulses only. A diode is a device which provides only one directional, it is a unidirectional device. So again, we need to use a diode to provide only a positive cycle of a AC. Next one is a pulse triggering. So pulse triggering. So there are pulse transformers also available that we can use for isolation between a control as well as a power circuit. The main advantage is that there is no need of applying continuous signals, so the gate losses are reduced. So in case of a DC, we know the DC which is constant, the frequency of a DC is zero, so the continuously we need to apply the voltage source. So that is the power loss is more in case of a DC. But in case of a AC, periodically it will shift from positive peak to negative peak. So for again, there is also that is a drawback. Here, pulse gate triggering are required amount of a pulse we can generate here for the required duration. So continuously, whenever we need to start the device, at that time we can give the pulse. So that is possible. That's the advantage of this pulse gate triggering.